But you know, it just,
it's nowhere close to 40.
The only thing is the aura of the fight. Now the fight's being talked about because it now is going to that glamour, like, oh, Mayweather, Pacquiao, ooh, wow. But also, you gotta understand, people that don't know the business, you know, people could criticize anybody, they could criticize me, could criticize him. Knowing the business, seeing the business, it all comes to dollars and cents. You know, who makes the most money, what, and now also there's two promoters involved, you know, who's in charge of promoting.
Yeah.
And also, not even, and on top of that, two networks, Showtime and HBO. So there's more to it now.
Remember, well, Floyd has four fights left at the MGM, right? Four fights left right now?
Floyd. Yes. But, you know, but Floyd wasn't retired before that. You know, he's not going to have four fights on Showtime and fight Pacquiao. I don't think, you know,
maybe that will make him 50 and 0. That will be his 50th fight.
But, you know, in time, you know, he is getting older. They're both getting older. And, you know, the more time the fight doesn't happen, people are going to lose less and less interest in it.
That's what I thought. But now people are interested. People are
telling me they want. Yes, right now we just saw Manny win. But yet again, remember, but Mike Tyson and Lennox Lewis, they were both, Lennox Lewis was part of HBO, and Mike Tyson was part of Showtime. And they did a conjoined thing to fight each other. You know, at that time, that was the highest.
But that wasn't Tyson in his prime.
Yes, but still the aura of it.
Right, but people got into it.
And exactly, we could say the same thing about Manny. He beat a guy that was tailor-made for his style. This, and that, you know. The aura is still there. It may not be back like when Tyson could have fought like 4 or 5 years ago before that fight, but same thing with Manny and Floyd. It could have happened two, three years ago, but it didn't. Now it's being taught. So it becomes who takes charge of it, who has the upper hand, and right now the upper hand is on Floyd's side. And you know, he's been the bigger names in the business. Now, the Pacquiao fight is being mentioned. You know, it's talking about being mentioned. Pacquiao, first they were talking about Amir Khan. Now, since Pacquiao won, now they're looking for a possibility to make that fight. And
I still think it's going to be Amir Khan next.
Could be. I talked to...
Speaking of Amir Khan, by the way, really cool dude. You know what he's doing? He's doing a major fundraiser, a sold-out fundraiser, to help the victims in the Philippines.
You see,
he doesn't have to do stuff like that. He's not even Filipino.
You know, a lot of... That's, you know, besides... I know we all criticize certain people for their accomplishments as a fighter, but you cannot take nothing away from Amir Khan, Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao. Besides the good things they do for the community, you know.
Brandon Rios, there's a lot in the community. See, Kids for Cancer all the time.
See, he does, you know, that's one thing that needs to be thrown out to the public. People don't really know that. They criticize these fighters for certain things that they don't do. They criticize, oh yeah, they're this, they're that. They don't fight this guy, they don't fight that guy. But like I said, at the end it comes to dollars and cents. And then when they do certain things for the community, that's a big, you gotta admire people that do stuff like that, because those are things that are never mentioned. They're never mentioned. That's why the people look at guys like Floyd and Brandon and all these guys are stupid or arrogant. They think they're this and that when they're not. You know,
Floyd does a lot for charity too. And so does Manny. And now Manny's in trouble in his own country for taxes.
That you see.
But he gives away all his money to charity.
See, that's something that needs to be worked on, or somebody needs to say something about or mention it to the public. But guess what? The only media that does certain things like that is you. Everybody's a critic. The one thing that you're doing that most people don't do, you're going out there.
Yeah, when have you ever seen Dan Raphael in a gym? Ever?
No, never.
Is he welcome here if he came?
He's welcome.
Okay.
He's welcome, but it's just, you're going from gym to gym, from trainer to trainer, from little trainer to big time trainer. You know, I cover boxing.
That's what I do.
You cover boxing. You cover, and I bet if money wasn't an issue, you would be going across the country to interview.
Absolutely, I get invited everywhere. I'm going actually to Rhode Island for 4 days, leaving Sunday.
Enjoy it, man. You're gonna see.
You're gonna go cover some
of the
fights.
Things that people don't really know.
It's gonna be cold out there.
Good luck with that.
There you have it, right here. Major props to Amir Khan for raising money for the victims in the Philippines. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting.